Hi everyone, and welcome to this video, which is my first look at the new Fast Friends Alpha content for Oxygen Not Included. I may well make this its own series, as the bigger updates land during the alpha and beta testing, so let me know if you find this interesting. And if you're not familiar with Fast Friends, then this is new content from Klei, which is in early development and can be accessed as an open alpha. To enable this content to try it for yourself, right click on Oxygen Not Included in your Steam library, go to Properties, Betas, then select Public Testing. This will update your game to enable this testing content. Beware that this is likely incompatible with saves from the released versions of the game. Also be aware that these versions will have bugs as the devs test out new ideas. And you can submit any you find through the Klei forums to support development. With that said, I'm going to jump into the new content as it currently stands, but of course this will change quite rapidly, so this information will soon be out of date. There are many changes, optimizations, and fixes that have been made, as you can see on the forum post announcement here, which I've also linked in the description. I'm not going to cover them all, but there are some notable changes. For example, poker shells have been rebalanced, and grooming and shearing stations now improve the husbandry attribute. Use the link to the forum to read the latest info yourself. The main things I want to cover though are the new bits of content. And firstly, we have four brand new dupes. These being Pell, Steve, Amari, and Quinn. Of course, these dupes are much like the existing cast, but it's always nice to have new faces. In addition, there's new overjoyed and stress reaction traits that dupes can have. With the Yodeler trait, overjoyed dupes will sing in happiness, as you can hear. And almost as an opposite, stressed dupes with the Banshee trait will wail unpleasant sounds, although this bugged out when I tried to record it. There is also brand new clothing, accessed with the new building, the Clothing Refashinator. This currently takes a snazzy suit and 3 units of reed fibre to make one of 12 new very colourful outfits, and the operator requires the tier 2 aesthetic design skill. They all have the same insulation value as the snazzy suit, and increase the decor bonus from 30 to 40, which is a nice buff, as well as looking very fashionable indeed. But the big addition in the Fast Friends is the new friends themselves, these being the new critter morphs. There are 4 new ones currently, and they are the Delectavole, Sanishell, Oakshell, and Cuddle Pip. I'll briefly cover each one to explain why they might be useful, and how they work. Bear in mind of course that these details will almost certainly change as development continues. Starting with the Delectavole, this is a shovevole morph in a brown colour. To get these, voles need to be ranched in a 60 to 100 degrees Celsius environment. As the name suggests, this morph is food related, but perhaps surprisingly, it actually provides only half the meat of a regular shovevole on death, at 8,000 kilocalories. What they do give though is tonic root, which is gained when sheared, but the voles do need to be fed regolith. This is used in a new recipe at the gas range for curried beans, along with nosh beans and formerly pinch of peppernut, which has now been removed. Unfortunately, this is only a great quality food item, which are less commonly made. This is because they're difficult to make early on, and later on you may as well aim for the best tiers of food, which makes these a little irrelevant. A recent change gave this food a +3 strength buff, which is nice, but not hugely beneficial. In its current state then, the Delectavole isn't really super useful. So next up is the Sanishell and Oakshell, which are 2 new poker shell morphs. Sanishells are made by leaving poker shells in normal water, and oak shells are made when in ethanol. The Sanishell is simpler to explain, and produces 4,000 kilocalories of raw shellfish on death, which can be cooked into 6,400 kilocalories of cooked fish. Therefore, these could be an alternative to pakus for cooked fish production. They have an additional benefit of cleaning germs in its surroundings when in liquid, so could also have a niche application there. The oak shell is probably the best new morph currently, and acts as an alternative way to get lumber. It drops a small oak shell molt when maturing, and a full oak shell molt regularly when fed, and on death. But they only drop molts on land, so this needs to be balanced with the ethanol to keep making more oak shells. Here is what an example ranch might look like, with mostly an ethanol pool. The key idea here though is to take the molt, crush it into lumber, then turn the lumber into ethanol which can be burned for power. As the ethanol distiller makes more polluted dirt, if we can make more than the oak shells eat, we can scale this up very easily. But if we get back less polluted dirt, then it becomes very tricky to sustain even small numbers. Here are three possible setups with oak shells, the top being tamed and not fed, the middle being fed and groomed, and the bottom being fed and tamed but not groomed. Of course, they will need to be tamed and groomed to increase the population, but for making sustainable ethanol production, currently ranching needs to be a mix of fed and groomed and starvation ranched. The numbers here are the average polluted dirt output from calculating across an oak shell's life cycle, and some credit goes to Fradow, who has a very informative forum post, which I've also linked in the description. And the final new critter morph is the Cuddle Pip, which is an even cuter variant of the pip. These critters are made when pips are fed thimble reeds instead of the normal arbor trees. The benefit is in cuddling eggs, similar to the incubator, but a lot less powerful. For the numbers, an egg by itself will incubate at 5% per cycle, hatching in 20 cycles. Using an incubator with the lullaby buff increases this by 20%, so hatching in 4 cycles. A cuddled egg increases by 5%, so hatching in 10 cycles. And eggs can be both incubated and cuddled for a total 30% incubation rate, hatching in 3 1/3 cycles. All in all, the benefit is fairly minor, especially compared to an incubator, so I struggle to see how this currently brings a lot of benefit. They sure are cute though. So that's all for the main points in the Fast Friends Alpha initial release. I hope this maybe inspires you to give it a go, and thanks for watching.